Once again, good evening, everyone, and welcome to the celebration of Mass this evening and the feast of the Nativity of St. John the Baptist. Normally, we celebrate the death day of the saint, but for John the Baptist, because he is the herald who proclaims Christ, we celebrate his nativity. And without getting too anxious about this, it also focuses us a little bit on something that will happen on the 25th of December, Christmas. We're already starting that process, perhaps, preparing for Christ to enter our hearts and our homes for his incarnation. Let us turn now, seeking God's blessing as always, and pray together. There is also a sprinkling rite this evening, reminding us of our own baptism. When we enter the church, we dip our fingers into the holy water fonts. We bless ourselves, as always, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen, but with these waters of baptism through which we also were saved. And so let us pray together, my brothers and sisters, asking our Lord to bless the water of these vessels, which we will use now in this sprinkling rite, reminding us of the day of our own baptism, the day we were called into discipleship with the Lord Jesus and given the Holy Spirit as well. Almighty, ever-living God, who willed that through water, the fountain of life and the source of purification, even every soul should be cleansed and every soul given the gift of eternal life through the living waters of baptism. Be pleased, we pray now, to bless the water of this font, by which we seek your protection on this day of the year. We celebrate the baptism of John, we celebrate the nativity of John the Baptist. Renew the living spirit of your grace within each of us, and grant that by this water we may be defended from all ill of spirit and body, and so approach you with hearts made clean and worthily receive your salvation. We ask all this through Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen.
Yeah. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you. Ah, Lord God, I said, I know now how to speak. I am young. But the Lord answered, say not, I am too young. To whomever I send you, you shall go. Whatever I command you, you shall speak. Have no fear before them, because I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Then the Lord extended his hand and touched my mouth, saying, see, I place my words in your mouth. This day I set you over nations and over kingdoms, to root up and to tear down, to destroy and to demolish, to build and to plant. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Prophets who prophesied about the grace that was to be yours searched and investigated it. it was revealed to them that they were serving not themselves, but you. With regard to the things that have now been announced to you by those who preach the good news to you, through the Holy Spirit sent from heaven, things into which angels long to look. The word of the Lord.
Reminds us to stop and to reflect. reflect on what God calls us to do. John the Baptist is one of those significant figures in the gospel who has more than one feast day in our church year. He has a feast, and a vision no less than tonight for his birth, and he has a feast day for his martyrdom on August 29th, which also has a vigil mass. He's important because of his role in preparing people for the coming of the Messiah and his call for their repentance, asking them to turn back to God and make a profound change of heart towards God and God's values. John also is an inspiring example of someone who refused to water down his message for the sake of popularity. He proclaimed the challenging message of God, often in the face of much resistance. John the Baptist is another sign of the ageless consistency of God's word, that God's laws and God's values do not bend to the trends and the fads of the times. Our Lord himself said of John the Baptist, "What did you go up to see in the wilderness? A reed bending in the wind?" John was not a pushover, but proclaiming God's message. No trendy sellouts, no watered-down messages, no political spins from John. Today's feast is part of the unfolding of God's plan, in and through the hopes and dreams of his faithful followers. John, Mary, Elizabeth, and eventually even Zechariah, believed and trusted in what God was doing in their lives, and they cooperated fully. One of the most important points of today's feast is to remember the message of John the Baptist. It is a reminder to us that it is not about numbers or about the majorities. Even if there's only a small minority who raises objections about something that is wrong and unjust, their voices are important. And even if a majority of people declare something to be so, it does not mean that is morally right or just. The example from John the Baptist is that all that matters is one voice, one true voice, speaking God's message. A lone voice crying out in the wilderness is a voice certainly worth listening to. John was willing to pay the ultimate price for standing up for those values. So even if the majority of our world is off chasing the next fad, the voice in the wilderness, a voice like John the Baptist, can still speak the truth without fear. John prepared the way for the Lord. He spoke of the values of the kingdom without compromise. And we are asked to do the same in our lives.
O Lord, you lead us to the truth. You lead us to justice. You lead us to follow you and be disciples in the world, continue to build your kingdom. And so, Lord, we gather together this day, becoming aware of these needs. We are voices crying not out in the desert, but in the midst of our daily lives, asking you to listen and hear our many prayers.
For all who have eyes, that they have courageous witness and strong faith, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For local and national leaders, that they make thoughtful decisions and execute them with careful planning, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families expecting the birth of a child, that they have a safe pregnancy and healthy delivery, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For communities, neighborhoods, and extended families, that they enjoy loving communications and general mutual support, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who gather at this table, that they experience patience, tolerance, and a sense of humor, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lead the departures of the light of your dwelling place, including John Fetko and Marilyn Calico, that they may gaze upon you for all eternity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions listed in our parish book of prayers, and for all the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For every continuer in this day, all the poor souls in purgatory, as well as all those who stand in need of prayer, that they would know that they are not alone, and that we, your people, are praying for them. For you have called us through the waters of salvation to be your people, to be baptized in Christ, and also to become disciples. Disciples are called to continue to build the kingdom, continue to witness to your Son, as John the Baptist did. May we continue always to follow him, the Baptist, as well as Christ, until we come into your kingdom one day, where we will live and reign with you forever and ever.
Amen.
If you did not prepare the table to celebrate the Holy